Many people are interested in birds' nests, why they're built, how they're built, and a little bit about what birds use them for. We're going to learn all about that today with Doris Watt, and we are here at St. Mary's College campus in South Bend, Indiana, and you are a biology professor. And you specialize in ornithology, right? You got your PhD in that, so you teach an ornithology class right here at St. Mary's. And you've got all kinds of birds' nests. So thanks for having us here on campus.
Well, you're welcome.
And you have found for us a nest that we can look at right off the bat, right?
Yes, I have.
All right, what do we got here?
We have an old robin's nest. Robins are the most common nesting bird in the state of Indiana. We have robins all over various different habitats, in yards and around people's homes and in the woods. They use all kinds of things to build their nests.
Yeah, it's like what do you
some
think this
kind
is?
Of nylon or some
that
kind
they
of man-made
shredded.
Substance.
Yeah.
But I have here also an old robin's nest we can look at. The major thing about robin nests is they have a lot of mud in them.
Right.
And that distinguishes their nest from many other species.
And of course they carry that in their beak, right?
Yes. Okay. Yes, kind of a messy thing.
Yeah.
They also put a lot of grass in, but they don't weave it, they just line it with grass.
Oh, and then take a look at this.
A piece of plastic.
Plastic, yeah.
Yes, a lot of birds put different kinds of things in their nest. They may think it's a decoration.
Mm,
we don't really know.
Okay.
Some of them put snake skins in there.
Nest. All right. So all kinds of things.
And another bird that has a nest that is made of grass but doesn't use the mud is the red-winged blackbird. This is another common nesting bird in Indiana. And this is an example of a red-winged blackbird nest. And again, it's not really woven. It's just the grass is kind of layered in here.
Okay.
They often put it in cattails to hold it up.
And so no mud, so that's how we kind of tell.
Right.
We can kind of see this one actually shows how it's connected to the cattails, right?
Yes.
Amazing. Okay. Why do birds build nests? What's the point?
A lot of people think that birds actually live in their nests like a home, but they actually only use them for the eggs. So birds lay their eggs and then they incubate the eggs in the nest until they hatch. And some birds actually, the young grow up in the nest.
Okay. All right. So it's like a nursery.
Yes.
So to speak, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
And then when they're done with it, they usually leave and don't use it again.
Okay.
Some birds re-nest in them.
In them, especially bigger birds like some of the raptors re-nest in their same nest. But most of the ones that we're going to look at are songbird nests today.
Yes.
So I'm going to set this down and maybe we can kind of walk around here because you've got a bunch more. Let's see what you got.
And another one that uses grass, but it's actually a woven nest. These are two examples of Baltimore oriole nests.
Little pouches,
They're suspended from branches in a tree, and they actually weave the fibers, the grass and the fibers, into a very strong supportive structure that's stretchy.
Yep.
And that one's also one.
Yeah, amazing. Interesting little color variation too, depending on where they gather their materials what they found in their environment to be able to.
And these are old nests. If they were actually new nests, they would be green and look more like a tree.
More like
they
camouflaged
so
into
obvious,
the tree.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. All right. Okay. Well, and then some of the other materials here that you have for nests are pretty intriguing because there's a broad diversity of nest materials. And can we start with this one? Really think this is cool.
This is a chimney swift nest.
Which really is not much of anything, is it?
Just a few little sticks held together with mostly saliva, which hardens as a kind of a glue and holds it on the inside of a chimney.
And this is
a chimney swift specimen.
This is a taxidermied chimney swift, so it's not a very large bird, and as you said, inside a chimney is where they attach this, right?
And there may be four eggs laid in this little nest, and four babies grow up in there without falling out.
Which is amazing, and it'd be attached kind of like a little ledge on the inside of the chimney, right? Okay, all right. And then this is one that people are really interested in. Hummingbird, right?
Hummingbird nest. Here we have a male hummingbird, a female hummingbird, and one that has its wings spread, so you can see how small they are. This is the nest, and in that nest the female hummingbird will lay two eggs and hatch two babies, and two little hummingbirds will grow up in that nest.
Yeah. about this, as I recall, the eggs are about the size of a pea.
Yes,
is that about right?
Yes, so
pretty
about
tiny.
Right. Okay. And they decorate it with little lichens stuck on the outside.
It's beautiful.
So it's really hard to see when it's up on a branch.
Actually on the tree, yeah. Okay. All right. And then this is, this one has a little tag
here.
Here
we have a barn swallow.
Yeah.
And the barn swallow nest, that it's very difficult to collect them. They fall apart almost immediately when you touch them. So each one of these little round things is a mouthful of mud that the barn swallow brought in and stuck together when it was wet.
Uh-huh.
And so then it dries and makes this kind of framework. And a lot of barn swallows in barns, of course, have different things they line the nest with. Here we have some horsetail hairs.
Yeah, from a horse.
And some chicken feathers.
Wow.
And so those all go to help provide a home for the babies and the eggs.
Okay, and how about this one? So
and
beautiful.
This is one of my favorites. This is the eastern phoebe nest. And if you see the nest itself, the lining is lined with plant fibers, little stems, and also little pieces of deer hair.
Yeah, look at that. So it's wrapped kind of around, and that just provides a cushion, right?
Right. Yeah. And then around the outside, the phoebe puts moss, and at the time it's green, and so it looks like moss. And they build their nest up underneath something, so they fly up into a hidden little nook under our deck.
Are there rules about collecting nests?
Oh, yes. All birds and their parts and their nests are protected by federal law, and it's technically actually illegal to pick up a piece of a bird, like a feather or a nest or a dead bird, and it's against the law to have those in your possession.
Unless you have
a
federal permit.
And the federal permit, we have one here at St. Mary's that's for our museum,
right?
And so we are allowed to collect these for educational purposes.
Right.
Okay. Other museums and places collect things for research purposes. Ours is totally educational.
Okay, so that's a good point. So, and another thing I like to mention to folks is it's pretty hard even with the stuff that we saw on that robin's nest to see it in there. But a great time to look for nests is in late fall after all the leaves have fallen, and in winter because people can walk and hike and kind of see the variety.
Right.
So not all nests are built in the same kind of location. Sometimes they're just scrapes on rocks. Sometimes they're built in houses or cavities. Sometimes they are woven into the sides of the trees. So there is a great variety of bird nest locations as well.
Yes.
Yeah. All right, Doris, this is so much fun because people are really intrigued about birds' nests. And you have a great resource here if people want to learn more about birds' nests, the Field Guide to Birds' Nests and the Peterson Guide series. It has really good photographs of different kinds of nests and descriptions about the birds. And we'll have information about that on the Outdoor Elements website. Doris, thanks so much. This is great information about birds' nests. Thanks.
You're welcome.
Coming up, backyard bird feeding is a great way to connect with nature. And different bird species enjoy different seeds depending on their bill structure and feeding habits. We'll get tips on selecting seeds to set out a feast for the birds. Like Outdoor Elements? Then like us on Facebook. It's your chance to keep up on what's airing on this week's Outdoor Elements. See behind the scenes pictures and videos. Observatory to offer heat throughout the winter, and they're using computers. Be sure to check out the galleries. We also want to hear from you. Let us know what you think about the show and some of the great outdoor elements that you are experiencing. So search Outdoor Elements on Facebook or connect via WNIT.org/outdoor elements. And be sure to click like